Obviously, you watch the news and the rest of this stuff, and you hear what folks have to say. Earlier this week, the two councilmen at large, I won't say attack you, but certainly their contention is that you don't understand the scope of the violent crime problem here in our city. Mm-hmm. To what do you say, Mayor Cantrell?
Mm-hmm. You know, when I hear that, it's an insult. Quite frankly, me not understanding what's happening on the ground and in this city, having been a crisis mayor since day one in public safety, has not been separated from that. Being a black woman, raising a black daughter in the city of New Orleans, having experienced crime firsthand myself, me and my family, a police chief that has been an officer and of this community for over 25 years, men and women of the New Orleans Police Department that are majority from the city of New Orleans, we're all on the front lines and have been in the arena fighting what we have seen to be an uptick in crime in our community, particularly when we started in moving through this COVID-19. We absolutely saw record numbers coming down in 2019, but no doubt about it, we've experienced an uphill fight, but we are fighting. And the men and women, we're getting things done. As of like July 4th, for example, with the July 4th weekend, you know, 40 arrests were made for illegal guns, 45 illegal weapons seized. June, the month of June, over 484 arrests for felony charges made by the men and women of the New Orleans Police Department. So not only do we understand, we're in the arena doing the job, not only intervening, always remaining engaged, looking at preventative measures as well. And so we are doing the job and will continue to do the job. Hurt people hurt people. We have a lot of hurt people in the city of New Orleans, and I've seen it and see it firsthand. That's why the majority of our homicides and shootings in our city are those of domestic violence and abuse. People who have relationships, people who do not know how to solve or resolve differences without resorting to violence. That's what I see in our community. That's where I show up. And you know what? Even today, graduating and loving on over 125 of our youth that were somehow system involved, but were provided an opportunity to work during the summer, over 93% attendance record, that's meeting our young people where they are, that is treating root causes to ensure that they stay on and get on a path so that they can reach their fullest potential. I was there. You know who wasn't there? And where I've never seen the council members that you mentioned show up at anything relative to prevention, intervention, as well as response. But where I show up is always on the ground with the men and women of the New Orleans Police Department and with teams that have been put in place to serve our community through the Office of Youth and Families, Violence Prevention. We are in the arena and we're not leaving. We're seeing that we're moving in the right direction, but yes, we do have an uphill battle, but we continue to fight. So listen, people sitting on the sidelines can say whatever they want, but when you're in the arena, it's a total different story. And the men and women of the New Orleans Police Department deserve respect. They deserve support, and especially from our city council.
Mm-hmm. One more question on that, and we're going to leave that alone, only because what they claim is that you won't recognize that our city is being in crisis in terms of violent crime. Do you consider it a crisis, Mayor?
Listen, I have been in crisis mode since I've been mayor, and it's been 4 years now, and public safety has been one of those crises, those challenges that we continue to face and to get results on. So absolutely we know the numbers. We know the families. They're not just a number. We know the impact that it has on our community. Trauma is real. Hurt people hurt people. And that's why looking at root causes and putting resources where they need to be, that's what my administration is doing. We will continue to do that. But also when we talk about the second allocation of the American Rescue Plan dollars, which I fought single-handedly with mayors across this country because we need these dollars, we have them in, and where I would like them allocated specifically, $46 million for public safety. That is in alignment with what I'm hearing from residents in the city of New Orleans, giving our officers the tools and resources that they need to do the job. It's mighty funny, the city council has had one, facial recognition, for months now and haven't moved it along at all. That's a problem. So we need to work collaboratively. I'm up for that, but my men and women of the New Orleans Police Department, our department, we're continuing to work with Louisiana State Police, Operation Golden Eagle was one, ATF, the federal partners. We're on the job, we're in the arena, and we're not going anywhere.
Just to let you know real quick.
So Mayor, you got a new battery in?
I'm good.
Okay, good. Mayor, you mentioned the Office of Family Services and some of the social programs. You and I have also spoken about recruitment for the NOPD prior to. So many of those issues require time to work. And while they certainly are important, what many folks are wanting to ask, or what we've been asked, is what is the city doing to try today to stop violent crime?
But citizens that do ask that question,
sure.
What do you say?
Sure, what I will say is several things. One, I'm going back to the facial recognition, which is a tool that NOPD has consistently asked for this ordinance to be amended to allow this tool to be back in the toolbox. In addition to that is our redeployment strategy, having our officers go back to 12-hour shifts, creating visibility throughout the city of New Orleans is something that we have seen have a positive impact. Our officers remaining engaged, we've made 484 arrests in June alone, which surpasses the arrests that we made even in 2019. So we're seeing record numbers there. But NOPD makes the arrest. What we need are consequences for those who are arrested. And that doesn't rest with me as mayor nor the New Orleans Police Department. We need to ensure that there are consequences for these criminals based on the actions that they render in the streets of the city of New Orleans. And that's what I'm asking for. That's what needs to happen today. Because if we're seeing the arrest, felony charges, we need these individuals to stay and remain off the streets of the city of New Orleans. We will continue to be engaged. We are continuing to push for our additional allocation of resources, funds for our New Orleans Police Department, our officers. Retention is a big issue. Recruitment as well, it goes hand in hand. So these are the things that we're doing today in addition to giving our young people something to do. That is something that sparks results right now. These are children that have touched our system right now, that we have moved them into work development and workforce opportunities right now where they're able to earn a wage. Nothing stops a bullet like a job, and we're demonstrating that. You also look at these young people that have not only worked summer, but they're on a job permanently in our community. These are resources that work right now. Even as it relates to trauma-informed care. This is happening right now, and it does have an impact, a positive impact, on violent crime in our community. So what I say, you have to do both and the city of New Orleans, we are doing it, but we also need the criminal justice system to operate as a system, and individuals who are arrested by New Orleans police need to ensure that justice prevails. We need to keep criminals off of the street. And that doesn't start. It starts with us getting them off. But keeping them off is not the job of the New Orleans Police Department.
Mm-hmm. Mayor, for citizens that see the council saying something, the mayor saying something, and many times at odds, in order for our city to work effectively, we have to be able to see you guys working together. Do you see opportunities where you can work with the council? And are you willing to work with them even further in order that our city is safer?
I am willing to work with any branch of government, any agency that renders our streets to be safe for residents and visitors of the city of New Orleans. No doubt about it, I've demonstrated that time and time and time again, and will continue to do so. So yes, I do believe that the public deserves its elected officials working together. I'm doing that. I'm in the arena. I'm not on the sidelines. So what I will say, join me in the arena. It's plenty of room for everybody. But we need to ensure that we're doing the best that we can to ensure that public safety is our top priority. I'm doing that as mayor. I will continue to reach out, no doubt about that. But I would agree, I would say, the public deserves to see us working together, and that's exactly what I'm providing.
The council today passes a resolution, or they were set to vote on a resolution regarding the council's stand, if you will, on abortion, on the striking down of Roe v. Wade mm-hmm. and the trigger law here in Louisiana. Mayor, speak to us about your stance on the abortion ban here in New Orleans, although they're able to currently have them because of, you know, what's going through the court system. And what do you envision the city being able to do to support mothers mm-hmm. of pregnancies that don't want to carry the term or are forced to carry the term?
So first of all, I commend all those who have stepped up. Our district attorney has rendered a statement in which I agree with in terms of not prosecuting mothers and or healthcare providers. I commend the New Orleans City Council for passing a resolution. It speaks and is definitely aligned with my thoughts and support of women in our community, but also around the state of Louisiana. It's very unfortunate that our state has found ourselves in a situation to where we will not support or render the support to our women throughout and healthcare providers, giving them the freedom of having a choice. But not only that, a freedom of their reproductive care is something that we're entitled to as human beings. I'm a woman, I'm entitled to it as well. So I will continue to stand by women in this state, in this city. I'm really working on creating a coalition, if you will, that will make sure that the city of New Orleans become a safe haven for women in our city, but also around the state, should this stay go away. But for right now, we know that women can continue to receive the care, and I hope that that continues, but I'm going to work with my team. We're already working on maternity health. We've been doing that since I've been in office. We'll continue to render that support and services to our women, to our mothers, but we will not stop or rest until they be met with the services and resources that they need to protect themselves, to protect their families. We know that the impacts will be on our most vulnerable, which are, in our community, Black women and brown women, no doubt about it. And so I will remain engaged and of service to them.
Final thing on violent crime, Mayor, if you had a message to the citizens, what do you want them to know about the work you're doing and about their safety and as a priority for you?
Well, first of all, is that no one is immune to one being a part of the solution and or part of the problem. You have to be active and you have to be engaged. We all have a role and a responsibility to public safety. If you see something, say something, no doubt about it. But what I will also say, you know, that there are programs that are working, but we need our community to be more engaged in ensuring that we meet our people where they are. Hurt people hurt people, and these hurt people are in our community, they're in our neighborhoods, they're even in our families. And so we have to allow ourselves to be vulnerable, to be honest about what we know and also about what we see to curb the violence that we experience in our city. We can do this. There is hope, But I tell you, we have to do our part, all of us. And we need a criminal justice system that works together. And that also includes not only the mayor, it includes the city council and all other branches of government. I'm committed to that. I cannot do it by myself. And we are really all in this together. And I'm just wanting to ensure the public that we will do, me as mayor, our New Orleans Police Department, men and women of our New Orleans Police Department and public safety team across the board, we're committed, but we need to support our police officers. We need to respect our police officers. And also I would say to those who have an issue with managing their feelings, just, you know, from, you know, one day at a time. And so for this day, I will just say, not today, not today. Get through today, tomorrow will come. And you say, not today, but one day at a time. But we have to learn how to control our feelings, our emotions, and not let those feelings get in the way and therefore allow us to step outside and cause harm to another human being. We have to control ourselves, and we can. We can do it. We're trending in the right direction. NOPD is making solid and sound arrests, more than we have seen in a mighty long time. You know, 484 in June. That 274 was starting at the beginning of the year. So we are doing it. We need arrests made, but we need criminals to remain off the street.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Mayor.